What's up? Today we're going to talk about how to draw a Lewis diagram for ionic compound and covalent compound. And second, we're going to talk about how to predict the single displacement. And thirdly, we're going to talk about the mole.
So let's start with Lewis diagram first. So the first thing we have to know, what is ionic compound and what is covalent compound? The first thing we have to look at the definition.
Covalent bond is an attraction between atoms that result from the sharing of electrons, which means they share the electrons. Ionic bond is an attractive electrostatic force between a negative ion and a positive ion. So that's a cation and an anion. They are transfer the electrons. And now we have to know the difference between the ionic compound and covalent compound. The difference is the electron activity. If the difference between two atoms negativity is smaller than 1.7, that's covalent compound. If it's greater than 1.7, that's ionic compound. Let's go to an example. Potassium oxide, it's an ionic compound.
So let's start from ionic compound. So potassium oxide. So let's see why it's an ionic compound, because the electronegativity, potassium is 0.8, oxygen is 3.4. So you minus it, it's supposed to be like this. So it's definitely gonna be, that's larger than 1.7. So it's an ionic compound. Let's draw this first. Potassium is plus 1, oxygen is minus 2. Because oxygen have have 6 in outside, so oxygen is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, minus 2. And potassium have 1 electrons outside, so it's plus 1, and plus 1. So if they share the electrons.
Based on octet rule, they all want to fill 8 electrons outside, and they are satisfied right now because they all have 8 outside.
So let's talk about how to draw the covalent compound, carbon dioxide. Let's start with determining why it's covalent. We know the electronegativities, and oxygen is 3.4, and carbon is 2.6, so minus is 0.8, so that's smaller than 1.7, so it's covalent. The first thing we have to count all numbers valence electrons. Carbon have 4. Oxygen have 6. And count together is 4 plus 6 plus 6, because we have 2 oxygen. So it's totally 16. So we're gonna have 16 electrons in the diagram. And so let's put the carbon in the middle because they need the most electrons. So the carbon will have 4, and oxygen will have 6. We have 2 oxygens. And the thing is, they're gonna share the electrons. And that's a single bond. They can draw like this and like this. But okay, so they have 6 in total, but the carbon also want to have 8 in the outer shell. So we can share with that, draw another bond together, another bond. And let's simplify, the diagram will be like this. So let's count it. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 8, 7, 8. So this is 8. And this is 4 multiplied by 4, that's 8. And this is also 8. So they are all satisfied. They all have 8. So this is OK.
OK, let's talk about the mole. We can consider a mole is a dozen, but it's now 12. It's 6.02 times 10 times 23. It's the same thing with a dozen. If you have this amount of money, you will have a mole of money. And the same thing, if you have this amount of CO2, you will have a mole of water. And then let's use an example to demonstrate how to transfer the gram and the mole in the chemical reaction.
Lithium oxide react with carbon dioxide, produce lithium carbonate plus water. And the question is 0.5 mole of water and how many mole of carbon dioxide and the weight in gram. So in this problem, we're gonna first see the ratio of the mole. So so the ratio is lithium oxide, 2 mole of lithium oxide, 1 mole carbon oxide, and this is all possibility in this question. And the question is ask us 0.5 mole of water and how many mole of carbon dioxide. So we should use this one because that's the ratio we need. So, and then we're doing like this. So because I choose some very easy one, so 1 mole and 1 mole. So we get the answer is 0.5 mole of carbon dioxide. And then we use the weight. The carbon dioxide, 1 mole carbon dioxide is 44 gram. So let's write the equation like this. 0.5 mole of carbon dioxide, and so we got 22 gram, because that's a half of the mole. Question number 2. 12 gram of lithium carbonate produced, and how many gram of lithium oxide we need to have in order to produce 12 gram of lithium carbonate. So the first thing is we have to look at the ratio, which one we're gonna use. So lithium carbonate and lithium hydroxide is this one. So we're gonna transfer the gram to the mole. We have to know how many mole of lithium carbonate we used. So the first equation, and we know the mole of lithium carbonate are 73.9 gram, and we put it here and we calculate it's 0.16 mole of lithium carbonate. And we use the risk ratio. We know if we know the ratio will always be 2/1. So if we input this one, and we'll get it's 0.32 mole of lithium hydroxide, and we have to calculate how many lithium one mole of lithium hydroxide is 32.94 gram. And then we put this one, if we know the mole of lithium oxide weight, and we know how many mole,
and then we can know the weight of lithium hydroxide. Okay, let's talk about single replacement and how can we predict single replacement by active theory of metal and for non-metal. So the thing is very simple. This is how single replacement looks like. But A must greater than B's activity theory. So let's take a look at some example and which one can react, which one can't. So we have to compare with copper and hydrogen. And let's take a look at the diagram. So we find out the hydrogen have a greater activity than the copper. So which means this reaction won't happen because copper are not available. He don't have enough activity to replace hydrogen. So the reaction won't happen. So the first one, the answer is no. And let's look at the second one, iron and hydrogen. And on this chart, we see the iron has a greater activity ability than hydrogen. So which means this reaction would happen. So the product is the iron will replace hydrogen and combine with chloride. Let's look at a third example, copper and iron. So which one is larger? And if we look at chart, we'll find the iron have greater ability than copper. So this reaction won't happen too. And for the fourth example, we need to use activity theory for non-metal. For the halogen theory, it's exactly the same thing with metal. We compare the two halogens' activity ability, and we compare with it. The one has greater ability will replace smaller one. And we look at the fourth example, the chloride and bromide. The chloride have a greater activity than brine, so this reaction will happen.